How do you not just like dance at in your chair at home to this song? I mean, anywhere you are, I couldn't help but do it. Do you dance every time you hear a song? No.
I love that song. Yeah, I mean,
now, Montreal is known for jazz and known for producing amazing jazz singers, and Melina Soochan is no exception to that. Thanks for being on the show.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
So you are releasing your third album. It's called The Velvet Lounge.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about the album.
Okay. So it's very much a concept album. So it's all about that, what you picture when you hear sultry jazz, New York bar of the 1940s.
Yeah.
It's very loungy, very smooth. A lot of bossa nova, ballads, blues, all the good stuff.
Right. And now you perform soul, but you also do it all. You do a little Motown. Tell us about
yeah,
the different
absolutely.
Things
so I have
do.
Several projects. One of the things I do is a jazz quintet called The Velvet Lounge.
Right.
And the other thing is more of a pop Motown soul cover band called Masters of Groove. We do a lot of the Dusty Springfield, Stevie Wonder, that kind of stuff.
Now, the
really
first
fun.
The first two albums were pop. Now, this
yeah.
why make the switch?
Well, you know, it was kind of a natural progression. I've always loved pop. I grew up in the pop world. I grew up playing classical, actually, when I was a kid on piano. But really, the more I was performing in the city, Montreal being such a jazz, vibrant city, the more people were requesting jazz. And I started to feel like the audience really respected and really responded well to jazz. And I really fell in love with it.
Okay.
And eventually, I was like, you know what? I want to do a jazz album.
Yeah.
I'm going to challenge myself and do this and see what happens. And you know, it came out wonderfully.
And now when you were a kid, were you always like, I'm going to be a singer? Like, did you sing in front of your parents or in the shower?
I was so shy, actually, as a
oh,
kid.
Yeah.
I was super shy.
You hear that a lot, actually, about singers that are so shy in
yeah.
person, but then they can get on stage and they can belt it out.
It took a while, actually, okay. to build that up. So I was writing my first songs at the age of 11.
Oh, wow.
But I didn't want to sing at all. I wanted to find someone else to sing my songs. The only reason I started singing is because no one would sing my songs.
That's so funny.
I was like, okay, I'll do it myself.
That's great. Yeah. Now, what were some of your influences?
At the time, it was more singer-songwriters of the
right.
90s, women singer-songwriters like Sarah McLachlan
oh,
or
Sarah McLachlan.
Alicia Keys when
okay,
she came out.
Great.
Those were big influences for me. People
yeah.
who played piano, sang, had really love songs and a lot of that stuff. Yeah.
Montreal jazz scene. Let's talk about it.
Yes.
I love it, but I'm not a singer. I mean, I sing at home by myself. But like as a real professional, what do you think of the scene?
Oh, it's good. It's good in Montreal. There's a few places you have to go to all year round. That's what people don't really know.
Yeah, tell us the sweet spots.
Right.
To go
so
check it
a
out.
Lot of times people think Montreal, they think Jazz Fest, and that's just one season.
Yeah.
But really, all year round, you have a few places to go to. There is House of Jazz, which is the best known place in Montreal, I would say. There's one in Montreal, one in Laval. They have live music every night, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. There's also Upstairs Jazz Bar for more purist jazz.
And that's like downstairs,
music.
Right?
It's actually
downstairs.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
It's
on McKay. And there's also Diaz Ons, which is another great one up on Saint-Denis. And a new one that opened up in the old Montreal called Biddles Jr. as well.
Right. And now why does Montreal have such a good jazz scene? Like, what's the history of jazz in the city compared to other cities in Canada?
I think just because of the European influence and everything, there's a lot of live music everywhere. And especially a couple of decades ago is when sort of the big boom of Montreal was really picking up. And I think it just kept up with it ever since.
Okay.
And it just, the Jazz Fest especially brings a lot of people into the city for sure.
Amazing. And now you have a launch that's coming up.
Tell
us a little bit about that, April 26th.
Right. So next week on Thursday, April 26th, it's going to be a 5-cassette at the House of Jazz in Montreal. I'll be launching my third album called The Velvet Lounge. And it's going to be a wonderful show. I'm really recreating the concept of a lounge. So you're going to have, you know, that sultry feel, really recreating the 1940s jazz bars of New York. That's
Very
the concept
cool.
of it.
And then after this, what's next?
Who knows?
Yeah.
Who knows? I'm hoping to get some good results from my applications to festivals this summer. I always have some shows at the Casino of Montreal as well from time to time, and a few other places, so I'll let you know.
Very cool. Melina Soochan, and we just discovered we actually used to be neighbors, so this is what a small world it is and what a small place it is in Montreal, not only good for the jazz. I used to hear her play jazz in the condo next to me, and it was very, very good, so now you can catch her live on April 26th at the House of Jazz. Thanks so much, Melina.
Thank you so much.
Coming up after on BT, the Daily Download.